local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
And right now on WYFF News 4 at 6, a memorial service is getting underway at Cleveland Park in Spartanburg. Tonight, a look at how the community is remembering the four who were killed 10 years ago at a motorcycle shop.
Schools close tomorrow for some elementary students to deal with a bat problem, the health concerns parents are worried about.
And the Reverend Billy Graham turns 95 tomorrow. Tonight we hear from his pastor about a new DVD and how their friendship helped to make that happen.
But right now, a live look here from Sky 4 over Cleveland Park in Spartanburg County. In that building down there, people are gathering for a memorial service for the victims of the Superbike Motorsports homicide. You may remember it. It happened 10 years ago in Chesney. The case is still unsolved. Scott Ponder, Brian Lucas, Beverly Guy, and Chris Sherber were all shot to death that day. And this week, investigators released a possible motive for the crimes. They believe a disgruntled customer did it, but they've yet to name a suspect. Investigators have been looking for a person of interest. Still no luck with that. Authorities are now reaching out to the store's online customer base, hoping for tips to help solve the case.
The Transylvania County Sheriff announced an arrest this afternoon in a 1996 cold case. 63-year-old Michael Owen is charged with murder. The sheriff tells us Edna Glaze was reported missing back in March of 96. She was last seen near the Brevard Music Center. Despite numerous search efforts, Glaze was never found. Well, today, Owen was arrested and charged with her death. He is being held with no bond at the Transylvania Detention Center.
Now to Buncombe County, where authorities have a new case of homicide on their hands tonight. The sheriff's office tells us the body was found at the Nacon Motel on Smoky Park Highway in Candler this afternoon. In fact, it was this morning. Deputies say they were called to the motel just before 11 o'clock. We're still gathering information about this, including how the person was killed. We're dealing with the sheriff's office on that. Investigators also are waiting tonight to release the victim's name until relatives have been notified.
To Anderson County now, where the Honeyapath police chief says there has been a rash of car break-ins. Get this, we're told the thieves stole more than 40 sets of car keys from the Carolina Ford dealership. Police say the thieves also stole a truck and an SUV, which was later recovered. Chief David King says he'd like to find the owner of the white truck seen in this surveillance picture. Anyone with information that can help with this case is asked to call Crime Stoppers 888-CRIME-SC. A reward is being offered. Classes are canceled for the rest of the week at Hartwell Elementary. Crews are trying to get a handle on a colony of bats that have made the campus their home. WYFF News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local in Hartwell, Georgia tonight. Mandy, why did the district decide to shut the school down?
Well, the superintendent told me it was to allow the contractor enough time to get the job done. And if you take a look above me, you'll be able to see what they're doing. That silver stuff right there is what they're using to seal all of the openings where a bat could get in the school. Now, after we went live here on Monday night at 6, photographer Kevin Moran and I saw and heard the bats flying out of one of the buildings. He was able to get some video for you. Now, today, crews from True Tech Wildlife Removal were out here. Once they close all the cracks, they'll set up exit devices so the bats can get out but not back in. Then small cameras will be sent into the walls to remove their droppings or guano, which can cause respiratory problems if it decays and is disturbed.
Right now, where the guano is at that we have noticed in the school can't be accessed, so it's actually a good thing because it's not being messed with, it's not being dustified, it's not, you know, in the air for people to breathe.
Now, parents are still very worried about this. They sent us pictures of what appears to be bat droppings on the campus. The superintendent told me his custodial staff is using a Clorox mixture to clean it. One parent of a special needs student said her son's asthma is acting up even more than usual to the point where he had to have breathing treatments at a hospital in Atlanta. Her doctor says the chances are slim that it's related to the bats, but she says her child is being given fungal medication just in case. And in the meantime, the superintendent here says that they will be disinfecting the entire school over the weekend. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in Hartwell, Georgia.
All right, Mandy, thank you for that. Well, think about this. Since 1955, the Reverend Billy Graham has appeared on Gallup's list of the most admired men in the world 56 times. Yet in a 2005 Gallup poll, 45% of young adults either had no opinion of him or had never even heard of Billy Graham at all. But the organization he founded is about to make sure the world hears from him again, starting tomorrow, in fact, as he turns 95 tonight. With help from arguably his closest friend and a new DVD, we get to see what is essentially the Reverend Billy Graham unplugged.
Every person here tonight can have everlasting life.
The big thunder that filled arenas has dimmed with age, but his pastor says the soul of Billy Graham still carries its own lightning.
Spiritually, a fireball. I mean, a fireball.
Duty is a marvelous trait. It's a pillar of character.
Pastor Don Wilton of Spartanburg First Baptist became Billy Graham's minister a few years ago, and together they spent weeks doing this.
Our country's in great need of a spiritual awakening.
A DVD called My Hope America.
Today, I'm asking you to put your trust in Christ. I'm going to ask you to pray this prayer.
Pastor Wilton, off camera, talked Billy Graham through this deeply intimate look inside the old Montreat home and determined heart of a man whose preaching captivated the world.
And the message is classic Billy Graham. It is so simple and so full of truth.
I want to tell people about the meaning of the cross.
And it is full of irony.
As I look back over my life, it's full of surprises. I never thought I would become friends with people in different countries all over the world.
In the DVD, the famous pastor to presidents reveals a humble heart, almost lonesome, and yet passionate in his call for spiritual awakening.
There is a way if you come by the way of the cross.
His conversation is never far from the Lord Jesus Christ.
Pastor Wilton believes My Hope America is likely Billy Graham's final on-camera witness.
Come to the cross.
To the Christian faith he has carried to tens of millions.
He is very deeply concerned. And he uses very strong spiritual language to cry out to God for our nation, for the soul of our nation.
Holding his parishioner's hand through the production has reminded Don Wilton that Billy Graham is far more interested in prayer than identity politics.
I've heard him many times praying for President Obama and for Michelle and for Sasha and Malia. And we do that often together. Mr. Graham believed, what was the good of making enemies with people? When you know Christ is the answer and you want them to come and hear that Christ is the answer.
The DVD does highlight young people, their deep spiritual struggles, and Billy Graham's belief in the power of divine love.
He loves you, willing to forgive you.
You will feel the love of God coming through. People will be drawn into the heart of God's love. When you get to the end of it, it's like, wow.
And to his pastor, after 20 years of their private conversation, the wow factor of friendship, like the Graham home place, has only mellowed with age.
I love him at an extremely deep level of my heart and soul.
My Hope America is actually a series of video pieces, and the Billy Graham Evangelistic Association hopes people will get the DVD and then organize showings of it in their homes. And we also understand this tonight, Spartanburg First Baptist will screen it here in just a few minutes, in fact. Its official release happens tomorrow night at the Grove Park Inn in Asheville as several hundred gather for the 95th birthday party of the Reverend Billy Graham. And, of course, WYFF News 4 will be there as well, live.